Hi, I'm Andrew, and this is Blaster Breakdown. Today, I'll show you how I put together my latest HPA blaster, the Super Cheetah. Out of the box, the Cheetah 2.0 is a pretty powerful, compact, mag-fed springer, but I've taken it to the next level with Spectre's Supercore, an Empire relay in the grip, and a bottle holding all the air I'll need. This one also features 3D printed pieces designed by Alex Stuckey in Melbourne, holding the receiver in place and supporting the magazine well. Before we start though, if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and it's always nice to know if people enjoy my content, so hit that like button too. All right, let's have a look inside. Okay, here we are with all the parts I need to put together my Super Cheetah. First of all, if you look very closely, you'll notice that this blaster is no longer clear the way it comes out of the box. You can't buy it this color. Instead, I've painted it with this Duplicolor or VHT Nightshades spray paint, which I bought from my local automotive supplies store. That's just a spray can, and I've used this on a number of my clear blasters that are now red, a Prophecy, Swordfish, so on, and I always get pretty good results with it. I've used it for the Talon magazines as well. Now, the 3D printed pieces I've used are designed by Alex Stuckey. He kindly sent me the files to have these printed. So we've got a muzzle piece here that holds the Supercore receiver, and two parts here that extend the magazine well. So I've glued the receiver into this piece. This chamfered edge is where the darts go in. This end has the thread for your barrel to screw into, and this piece has these little wing parts that clip into the inside of the shell on each side. So that's the front part. Then there's these two parts that extend the magazine well. Now, of course, the Cheetah is a magazine fed blaster under normal circumstances. Without these parts, there was quite a bit of wobble in the magazine though. Probably doesn't matter in its original Springer configuration where you're chambering darts by moving the barrel back and forth, but with the Supercore, of course, the pusher is loading a dart into the receiver at quite high speed, and I thought it prudent to have the extra stability that the lengthened magazine well gives to avoid the top of the magazine tilting one way or the other when that ram comes forward to chamber the dart. So these parts are just glued either side. The right side has holes that'll fit an M5 screw. On the left side, I've heat set these brass inserts. When I close it up, I've got these M5 screws that fit through and screw into the inserts, and that holds the bottom of the magazine well nice and firm. And then of course you've got the other screws around the blaster. There is another printed piece, a spacer, that fits in here. It looks like a donut, and what that can do is help center this pusher piece. I found it worked fine without needing that. The shell itself holds my Supercore in just the right position, so I didn't end up needing that piece. But if you try this, you might find that that spacer piece is actually useful. So see how it goes for you. Now, fitting the Supercore itself was only tricky in that you need to make quite a lot of space on the inside. So there's a lot of molding. It's a fairly narrow blaster, so some of the plastic is ground relatively thin, but it was just a matter of cutting away as much as I could until the Supercore would fit nicely. But now the front lines up just behind this ribbing here. At the back, I've got just enough space for the push fit here, and then that leads into the hose to my trigger valve. Fitting the trigger was again just a case of grinding out enough space on both sides of the shell so that it will sit nicely. I think I lose one screw post there, but that doesn't matter. So now we can see the activation button extends into the trigger guard section, and of course is activated by our trigger, which I've dyed black for looks, and I had to grind away a little bit at the back to fit against that button. And now when that's all held together, that activates that button nicely. And the final part to mount, of course, is my Empire relay. Now, this has a Empire relay adapter made by Spectre, and so that provides a female 1/8 BSP thread. And so I've just got a straight 6mm push fit piece screwed into that. Now, the Empire relay has these mounting holes. What I did was cut away the base so that this fits in and holds it relatively firmly, but obviously not securely. And then I lined up and drilled 5mm holes through both sides of the shell so that I can then feed a screw through and with the dome head nut, fix that in place. That's what I did initially, but I found there was still a bit of wobble side to side. Even though the relay couldn't move up and down, it could still tilt side to side, because there's nothing on the inside actually holding this left and right. So then what I decided to do was grab some of these locking nuts, and so by screwing those on the right depth and just popping these little nylon washers in, and then washers again and another pair of nuts, these could hold the relay centered. And then when I popped my dome nuts on, I would be able to stop it from moving up and down as it was before, but it also removes that side to side tilting, because maybe you can see through the plastic, each side is then clamped by those locking nuts. So that's how I've fitted the Empire relay, nice and firm, nice and securely. There's no wiggle or jiggle at all there. Okay, so then the final tricky thing was lining up the air coming in from my tank attached to the Empire adapter to the MJV03 valve, which as you can see is very tight and not at all well aligned. Now, if you're doing a remote line version of this, you can just have your air inlet sort of at the back of your grip and that doesn't matter. But of course here it's very central, and so you can see that there's not going to be any combination of push fits or adapters that are going to fit neatly. So I puzzled over this quite a bit, and I finally hit upon the solution I should have thought of at the start, was to use some 6mm coiled hose. So this has the same rating as the more stiff black nylon hose that I normally use, which will handle 150 FPS and more, which is more than I'll ever need for this. So I realized I could just cut a short length of that and just use it to loop around to join up my air inlet. So now I can have the Empire relay exactly where it needs to be, nice and firmly centered. I can have the MJV03 exactly where it needs to be, and the hose just fits wherever it needs to in this empty space inside the grip. So, of course, another little bit of hose at the top here, but there's our basic, simple, manual supercore setup. Supercore held in place, our MJV03 held in place, activated by our trigger, Empire relay is firmly fixed, and we can test it all, turning our air on. There you go, fires nicely. So other than the tightness of the fit, this is really quite a simple, straightforward, semi-automatic supercore build, and putting it together is just a matter of trying to make sure every piece stays in place as you do so. So we get our two screws here, and our trigger. Okay, so that's that. So we can see our trigger activates the MJV03 valve. I can go ahead and screw these ones on first. There we are. So I've got these M5 screws that fit in here. And I've just got some M2.6 hex head self-tapping screws, 12mm long, for the other screw ports. And there you go, that's all held together nicely. Now, of course, your choice of barrel. I've got this Monkey Mods red anodized one, just because red matches, and a Spectre's aluminium six string scar, so that just screws in to the receiver like so, and then attach this once more and see when I turn the air on It's about 70 psi. It's higher than I probably need. Not sure if you can see the pusher inside moving, but there we are. Okay, let's get some numbers from the Super Cheetah. I'm running at about 70, maybe 75 PSI. Got some red worker Gen 2s and some black bamboos, 10 of each. Put them over the crony and see how we go. Red Gen 2s first. Bamboos. One more. So I think about 70 psi or so is going to be just right for 300 FPS games. Okay, here we are, 50 feet from the target as usual. At 300 FPS, I think we can expect pretty good accuracy. So I've got 10 worker Gen 2s, the new red ones, to start with, and then some bamboos. Pretty good. Now the bamboos. Okay, I think one or two from each mag went high or wide, but the majority seem to be bang on target, so I would say this blaster is war ready. So there you have it. That's the Super Cheetah, a bottle on super core semi-auto HPA blaster. Please leave any questions or comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.